Maureen, there's just all kinds of stuff going on. The legislature, public policy around education. Just what are the big issues that people need to know about?
I think the big overall issue that people need to understand is that we're at a time in Georgia and the United States where education matters more than ever. In the past, we were allowed to have some kids fall to the wayside, kids who sat in the back row and kind of dozed off.
Right.
Those kids could find jobs. There were mill jobs, there were factory jobs. Those jobs are gone. So we're now asking schools to educate all students to levels that we never, ever expected before. So it's really a massive change. So we are putting more pressure on schools to produce better results. And unfortunately, at a time when money is limited. So in fact, there are a lot of stresses on schools right now and a lot of higher expectations. So I think as a result of that, we're all paying attention to school. President Obama has said education is the key to our future as a country. And you know, I think that's true.
Is there anything special about Georgia? I mean, Georgia has unfortunately not been one of the nation's top tier states when it comes to high school graduation, academic achievement. What's going on there?
Well, you know, Georgia hasn't had a history of valuing education, and simply because it wasn't necessary in the past. We had mills, we had agriculture. Yeah. We didn't need to have high skill workforce. And of course now, even jobs that before were considered jobs sort of that you could come out of high school and do, those jobs don't exist. Almost every job today is going to need some education after high school. So we have to play catch up. We are not a Massachusetts that's always put a higher value on education, has sent more of its population on to college. But we have to compete not only with Massachusetts, we have to compete with India and China. So it's a new world for Georgia. So we are playing catch up. And I think that message, although I think it's getting more well received, I think in some areas of the state, they're only now realizing that it's a new world and their kids cannot graduate high school and expect to get a job that will support them and someday a family. So I think that in that respect, we have to work a little harder, pedal faster.
But by the same token, we've had the Hope Scholarship, which there's no other thing like it in any state around the United States.
Although we have had some imitators, but there's nothing quite as generous as the Georgia Hope Scholarship. It got a little less generous this year. The Hope Scholarship's been really important, not so much in whether kids go to college in Georgia, but where they go. We mm-hmm. used to lose almost all of our high-scoring SAT kids to out-of-state privates or higher-performing public systems, and now those kids are staying in-state. I think the Hope Scholarship, because it's made at Georgia colleges more competitive, harder to get into,
right.
The high schools, in fact, have improved their game, so to speak. There's more AP classes, there's more rigor. So I think the Hope Scholarship is part of a larger effort to improve education in Georgia.